Good afternoon, students. We have already discussed the chapter on physical features of India. So many topics we had already covered. Now we had studied about the Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats of India. One question arises from this: compare Western Ghats to Eastern Ghats of India. So you have to note it down these comparison also and understand where the location of Eastern Ghats and Western Ghats. Now, first point we are writing in the Western Ghat is Western Ghat location means where is the location of Western Ghats. The name is also there, Western. Western means these ghats lie towards the western part of India, means this is the western side of Deccan Plateau. We had already studied the Deccan Plateau yesterday. So this Western Ghats lies on west side of Deccan Plateau. So move towards the Eastern Ghats, same thing. Eastern Ghats lie east side of Deccan Plateau. So this is the Western Ghat and this is the Eastern Ghat inside the mapping line of India. Okay, this next point is tell you these ghats are higher than the Eastern Ghats, means Western Ghats are higher than the Eastern Ghats because their mountain ranges are higher than the Eastern Ghats and its height around 900 meter to 1600 meter high, and in Eastern Ghats are lower than the Western Ghats and their height around 600 meter round. So here is the difference also in the height wise. Next point says that these ghats are parallel and continuous to western coast, means this is the western coast and this is the parallel to the western coast and continuous also. Continuous means there is no differences or gaps, means there are the parallel to western coast. So but Eastern Ghats are not continuous, these are discontinuous to eastern coast and many rivers flow into the Bay of Bengal from this side. So you can see in this map also these Western Ghats are parallel to Eastern Ghats and not gap between them, and see here in Eastern Ghats are so many gaps and these are the discontinuous. So I hope you understand what are the difference between Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats. This is the very important question for examination, so you can note it down. Now from this map we can move towards our next topic, the coastal plains, means we have already understand that those land area between the water body and land body, means between the ghats and ocean water, these plains are called coastal plains. These are covered with sand soil and ocean and sea waves are coming and going continuously on that land, so we are calling that the coastal plains. Obviously the coastal plains are east, western ghats are parallel to east western coast and these are divided into three coastal plains, means western coastal plains divided into three coasts. First, Konkan coast, both Mumbai to Goa. Then the Karnataka area is covered with Kannada coast and the Kerala coast are called Malabar coast. So these are the division of three different coastal plains. Now move towards the eastern coastal plains. There is so many gaps and so many rivers flow into the Bay of Bengal, but here are only two eastern coast division. First calling that Orissa and Jharkhand area, these are called northern sarkars, and move downwards this eastern coastal plains called that Coromandel coast. So I hope you understand what are the western and eastern ghats and what are the western and eastern plains also. So what are the coastal plains? So there is difference between the coastal plains and western and eastern ghats. So you can prepare the difference, the question also, you can understand and note it down, that map with map. So this point is clear to you. I hope you understand properly, note it down and learn today. Thank you.